breeding season for spring calf and herds that I do will probably not start until the first week in May. So there is time yet, hopefully, to get the cows out and get them on that rising plain nutrition and get the bull out as well. But I suppose it's a year between the cow being in a poorer condition and maybe the bull being in too long. It's a year for strict record keeping and observation. So if both are out, cow and bulls are out on the 1st of May, don't they need careful washing, particularly after the first 2 weeks to see the rhino repeats. It's a year to be vigilant when it comes to breeding this year, Catherine.
Hello and welcome to The Beef Edge, the Teagasc Beef Podcast, for all your latest news, information and advice for Irish beef farmers. I'm Catherine Egan, and with current extended rainfall, on this week's episode, I'm joined by future beef advisor Gabriel Trayers, based in the West, and Alan Dillon, DairyBeef 500 manager, based in the South, to get an update on what's happening around the country, tips and advice in the coming week to implement on farms. Gabriel and Alan, you're very welcome. What's the current situation on suckler farms across the country, Gabriel?
The current conditions, Catherine, are obviously weather-related and very poor conditions, and there's a long list maybe of what is happening on the farms. So the big issue, I suppose, is the ground is totally saturated. Turnout of stock is very difficult and been a challenge to get cows out. And that is a big issue. Talking to the farms there this morning, like 50 to 60% of the calf cows are still in. So that has a knock-on effect then of body cow condition. They're in on silage when they should be out on grass, and that will have a knock-on effect possibly on the breeding season. We want these cows in good condition going into breeding. So that could be a challenge for some farms. Also, priority stock like maiden heifers and bulling heifers are still being housed. And if you were to talk to you 2 weeks ago about fodder, I would say there's no issue. But the fact stock are still in now, fodder is becoming more of an issue. They're going into the reserves and maybe using older silages that might be of good quality. So that, as of now, is okay, but could become an issue if the weather doesn't improve. So I suppose it's getting cattle out is the big challenge. But I suppose, and the mood is quite low as well amongst the farms themselves. But I suppose look at the weather is going to improve. There's plenty of grass on the farms. It's just a matter of ground conditions hopefully will improve in the next week or so.
Thanks, Gabriel. Alan, something similar of a current situation on the dairy beef farms across the country that you're working with?
Yeah, I suppose it's mixed, I suppose. Again, I mean, right, we're dealing generally with a lighter animal going to grass than the likes of Gabriel. I suppose, look, we're talking about cattle that are probably only 300 kilos in a lot of cases going out onto grass. So you wouldn't need the ground quite as good as you would with suckler cows. In the eastern side of the country, there's been a good bit of grazing done in the last few weeks on drier soils. In the western side, virtually no grazing done at all. If you talk to people, they're on heavier type soils, more clay type ground in the likes of Limerick and maybe up along the western side and some parts of Cork, and that there would be a lot less grazing done. Look, where there is grazing done, there's a lot of damage here and there being caused. Look, where you're getting these wet nights and stock are out, there is significant damage to paddocks done here and there. And I suppose, look, there is a problem with fodder on some of the farms also. They're out and they're drawing silage in and buying silage for the last 3-4 weeks in some cases. So look, it's going to have a knock-on effect in terms of closing up ground for silage, in that we're probably going to have to go back into the silage ground maybe to graze a second time or something, maybe where we kept grazing through, I suppose, the bad spells, and there's some damage done and recovery is slow and growth rates are, I think, you're back to, you know, maybe a lot less than half of what you'd expect at this time of the year. They're very, very low on farms. There isn't much fertilizer, if any, gone out yet. But look, the next week is promised good. It's looking like it's going to pick up in the next couple of days, and there is hopefully a good dry spell coming. And look, it'll turn overnight, I suppose, if we do get to that situation.
And are farmers concerned with regard to breeding season possibly being delayed on farm? And as you mentioned there, the condition of cows at the moment.
Yeah, they are concerned. And as I said, those lads that are concerned about body condition have gone in with 2 kilos of meal to try and keep that up. Also, the maiden heifers are getting priority, getting meal as well indoors. And a lot of these farmers would never have been feeding meal to suckler cows, but the situation we're in now, they have to. Talking to them again, that don't really want to delay the breeding season, because that'll have a knock this year. They will have a knock-on effect on next year's calf performance. So if a cow is going to become a bulling start on the 1st of May, they will bull those cows. But again, it's just trying to get them out to grass to get them on a rising plane of nutrition as soon as possible. And maybe just going back to fertilizer, like my advice would be to farmers is to get the fertilizer into the yards as soon as possible this week, because the weather will change. You want to go out as quickly as possible and is to get the fertilizer into the yard, Catherine.
Most definitely, Gabriel. And you mentioned there the concentrate options. What options are there? What's good value at the moment for farmers?
Compared to purchasing bales, we'll say at 40 euros per bale is always probably a better option, because buying bales, you know, it's a bit like buying a lucky bag. You're just not sure what you're going to get. So if a farmer is short of fodder, he probably has no option other to go in with a bit more meal than he should have. And if he has enough certain amount of bales, like he can stretch that with the use of meal in a situation to keep the cows cattle fed.
And you mentioned there about breeding season continuing on farms. I suppose in some situations where AI is being used, it might be possible to pick up cows coming in heat on slats. But regards to majority of farmers using bulls, is a concern there with regard bull fertility at this time of year, considering normally this is something farmers would never have encountered?
Yeah, and the bull, I suppose, should be out now and acclimatising and have his feet checked at this stage and acclimatising to ground conditions. But the breeding season for spring calf and herds, that idea will probably not start until the first week in May. So there is time yet, hopefully, to get the cows out and get them on that rising plane nutrition and get the bull out as well. But I suppose it's a year between the cow being in a poorer condition and maybe the bull being in too long. It's a year for strict record keeping and observation. So if both are out, cow and bulls are out on the 1st of May, don't they need careful washing, particularly after the first 2 weeks to see the random repeats. It's a year to be vigilant when it comes to it's a year to be vigilant when it comes to breeding this year, Catherine.
Most definitely, and particularly with regard, you mentioned there, you know, watching cows and seeing the differences. Would there be more opportunity this year for farmers possibly to go in with an earlier scan compared to other years, or maybe a more regular scan?
Well, particularly after the first 30 days, like, well, just to monitor how the breeding season is going. So between either using AI or a bull, after the first cycle, they should be maybe doing a scan at that stage to see what the conception rates are and maybe highlight any issues if there are going to be at that stage. The pre-breeding scan is a help, but again, research from Chagos has said that will only show up a small percentage of problems. So I think the most important scan will be the one after 30 days to see what the conception rates are like. That would definitely be worth an option. Definitely would be an option.
Alan, I suppose across all herds, be it suckler or dairy calf to beef, there is health issues starting to arise, particularly in sheds at the moment. What advice have you for farmers that are encountering such issues?
Big problem is these calves that are still inside in sheds, maybe stock building up around them, other stock that should be out. So look, probably with the likes of Gabriel, he's talking about suckler calves, they aren't at grass and they're building up inside in sheds with a lot of bedding under them, etc. On the dairy calf to beef side, I suppose, look, you're normally expecting to have some of the earlier calves out by now, maybe putting them out to grass. That isn't really happening because weather is so unfavorable. Now, it might happen in the next week. But we have had issues with maybe scours and pneumonias and calves again. I suppose vigilance and early action is probably the priority there in terms of trying to avoid a major outbreak. I mean, if you do have a scour in calves, it's probably the first thing I would do is take a sample and get it taken to the vets. Most will be able to do a rainbow test on the scours, and they'll have a result there within a few hours for you. At least it will eliminate maybe, you know, the idea that it might be crypto or salmonella or whatever like that, you know, something that might be contagious within a herd. And I would say, look, if you do have scours, the main thing is get plenty of fluids into calves, you know, get a bit of electrolytes into them or whatever, just to make sure that they don't get dehydrated and get some further stomach upsets. I suppose straw bedding is a problem too. You know, what we're dealing with on a lot of farms is that straw is very scarce and it can't be got at this stage. You know, and God knows what will be there next year, the way it is looking. I don't know, but the way tillage crops are going into the ground, but straw is extremely scarce. And there is a tendency on farms, I suppose, skimp on straw and try and stretch out what you have as long as possible. It's not ideal, especially with calves. I suppose, look, if people have something else, like maybe old roughish hay or something like that, they could maybe put underneath straw and put straw on top of it again. It would allow straw supplies to stretch a bit or something like that, you know. But it's you have to keep that dry bed under the calves at all times. And it's around this time of year, I suppose, people maybe get a bit tired of it all and to get maybe a bit more lackadaisical about hygiene in sheds. And sometimes you can see little bits of issues arising, especially with some of those later calves that might come in and might be more exposed to pathogens inside in sheds. But that's mainly what we're seeing is that, you know, it's probably overcrowding and sheds. Cattle haven't got out to grass. There was no sign of any hope of getting them out up to now. And capacity in sheds is a breaking point in some cases.
And you mentioned there, Alan, that like some of the farmers there in the east have ground grazed, growth is slow coming back. With regard to farmers that have delayed the first rotation and grazing hasn't happened, what's the first steps in the next week to 10 days? Things are starting to turn, the weather is starting to improve. What's the first steps for farmers in that situation?
I would say, look, if you've nothing grazed, which is the case on most farms, I'd say at this stage, or very little grazed anyway, walk the farm and have a look and see what grass is there. And look, you're going to have a decision to make probably in the next number of weeks with regards, you know, grazing and silage, main crop silage and paddocks to be taken out and fertilizer applications. So look, you'd hope if the weather clears up in the next week, 10 days, that we'll have ground conditions fairly good sometime next week on most land, and heavier ground maybe the end of the following week. And really, I would say, look, if you are looking at having a huge amount of grass, you know, ahead of you that you were not going to be able to graze in normal times, I would say maybe look at taking out some paddocks early, you know, before the end of the month. If you can travel with machinery, don't be afraid to bring in the baler, pick up a bit of that grass that's starting to go to seed at this stage, probably are going extremely strong, you know, over 2,000 kilos dry matter, and bale it up and put it to one side. It'll be still reasonably good quality silage. If you know if it isn't growing for too long in last autumn, and follow it on then with a round of fertilizer or slurry and try and get that grass rotation back in sync again. I would say, look, with main crop silage, people also have a decision to make. I'd say on a lot of the demo farms, what the decision is go out with maybe 60 units of nitrogen or thereabouts in the next week and try and still cut around maybe, you know, the middle of May. It mightn't be as heavy a crop as you'd like, but at this stage, I mean, you're not going to get out with slurry. You may or may not have a chemical P allowance, and that's the big thing people have to watch as well, as the amount of chemical P that are allowed to spread. So if there is a chemical P allowance, you know, a lot of the farmers are thinking maybe go with 3 bags an acre, maybe 18, 6, 12, or something like that. Get a crop off there maybe around the middle of May again, and then go out with slurry and try and get a very early second cut. It's not ideal the situation we're in, but we're just trying to rectify it as best we can. And it's important there, I'd say, to be following on there, graze them heavy covers as well that are on every farm at the minute, you know, and get through them and follow on with some nitrogen to try and get a bit of leaf back in the sward and get a bit of recovery. And because you know you're going into, I would say, heavier covers than usual, you're probably going to have a probably slower regrowth, I would say, on farms. So you're going to have to budget for that. So getting out with maybe, you know, 20 to 30 units of nitrogen or a compound, maybe depending if you need to get out some chemical P and K as well, would be advised in the next number of weeks.
Thanks, Alan. And I suppose the situation is, in a lot of cases where stock would have been out in the last number of months, have grazed and might be coming into the sheds in the coming weeks, in a lot of cases that hasn't happened. What's the advice for farmers that are finishing cattle that would normally have been the practice, where a stock now are most likely to remain in sheds and be finished?
Yeah, I suppose if you look at where you're at the minute, I mean, you have two decisions now. You know, are you going to put them out to grass and try and finish them in July, or are you going to try and feed them on inside? I would say, look, if cattle are any bit forward at all, if they're, you know, over that 550 kilos or thereabouts for, you know, your typical steer or a heifer or whatever, I would say feed them on inside in the shed would probably be one of the best options if you have fodder there, I suppose, for feed them on for maybe 50 or 60 days. You should be able to get a reasonable fat cover at that stage, and you haven't gone there maybe, you know, at probably what would be a reasonable price point, you know, in around the 1st of June or thereabouts. Putting them out to grass at this stage, look, if they're not going to be out for another 2 weeks, they'll be fairly stale at that stage, cattle will. You know, they'll have been inside in the shed for 7 or 8 months. It'll take them a long time to catch up. As well as that, you have to watch, I suppose, the 30-month limit as well. You know, if you some cattle that have been born maybe in the month of late January or early February, they could, if they're going out very late, it'll take them a while to build up fat score, and you know, they start growing again, and you might end up having cattle that might slip over that 30-month mark there in July. So you just have to keep an eye on all these things. There's a number of factors that play in, but for demo farms, a good share of them are going to feed on to maybe some of the stock inside the shed, and try and get them killed as quickly as possible, maybe with a short 60-day finishing period rather than turning them out. But again, look, depends, have you fodder in the yard that you can keep feeding them that, or have you got slurry storage? You know, you should have space in the sheds, I imagine, next few weeks. That shouldn't be a problem, but can be benefits to it, but I suppose there's extra money to go out on meal, but it will bring cash back into the system that little bit faster.
Gabriel, the real thing is there is light at the end of the tunnel, and the issues that you've mentioned are really nationwide. Everyone's experiencing the same problems. It is an extremely stressful time, and there is huge financial pressure on farmers. What options are there?
There is financial pressure, yeah. And I suppose, look, pick up the phone and talk to your advisor is probably number one. Teagasc have their helplines in place. So even talk to your neighbour if you're a participant in a local discussion group. Every farmer is in the same situation. So talk to other people and you'll soon find that, look, you're not the only one. So even talking to your local bank, everyone recognises that farmers are in a tough position at the minute. So there's plenty of help out there, and maybe advice would be to go and seek it. It is where the mood might be low. There is, as a light in the tunnel, the weather is going to pick up. And I know some of the farms that I'm dealing with on the Future Beef Programme have fertiliser out. They have got silage ground closed. So that will all, with the increase in temperatures, that will all kick into place. This time of year, ground will dry out very quick. But I suppose, again, it's just get advice. There's plenty of people there willing to help. Your local advisor in particular that you might have a close relationship with. Everyone is willing to help out each other in a crisis like we're in at the minute, Catherine.
Most definitely, Gabriel. Like, there is an extensive network there of people to help, from merchants, banks, advisors, etc. And as you mentioned there, the helpline is available that farmers can ring from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Monday to Saturday. And the number is 059-918-3155, and I'll put that in the podcast notes. Thanks very much, Alan and Gabriel, for joining me, and some great tips and advice there for farmers. And as you say, in the next coming weeks, things will really turn.
Thanks, Catherine.
Thanks very much, Catherine.
That's all for this week's episode, and my thanks to Gabriel and Alan for joining me on the show. You can catch up on all other shows and interviews from the Beef Edge podcast on the Teagasc website at teagasc.ie, or you can listen on Apple and Google Podcasts as well as Spotify. Don't forget to rate, review and subscribe so you never miss a show. For all other updates from our beef programme, keep an eye on our Twitter and Facebook pages. Until next time, I'm Catherine Egan, and thanks for listening.